Alright guys, so I'm going to be showing you today how to do a strut replacement in Audi A4, 2-liter, quattro. And this is going to be without undoing this pinch bolt. Because if you're in a rust belt state, that pinch bolt will break trying to reverse it. And the nut might come off easy, but there's no way you're backing that out without specialty tools or the Schwaben tool, which is like 30 bucks. And I ordered one, it's in the mail, but it didn't get here quick enough. The shocks got here quicker and I just didn't want to wait. And I found actually pretty good method for doing this. Did the other side in like 2 hours, but I'm on jack stands and I had done it for the first time, so I'm guessing the side's gonna be quicker. So thing that we're gonna be undoing first is the this bolt here. And you stick an 18 millimeter wrench on the other side and an 18 here, and zip it off with your impact. And then from there, we are actually gonna undo the, with the shock bolt out, and you can leave the lower control arm bolt in, you can get this slipped over, you know, with the wheel turned to the right. And now he's gonna straighten it, I believe, right?
Yeah.
Straighten it back out. And we have one bolt in up there. Yep, okay, stop. Yep, that's good. And the one bolt up there allowed us to spin this a little bit and let us get this outside
of the control arm. Sorry.
What we did now is turned it all the way back with the wheel facing straight, I believe.
Yeah.
And we were able to lower this whole assembly with the arms on, and it is outside the lower control arm. And so now you have access to this bolt, and then you can spin this around and stick your gun in there and have access to that other bolt and take the whole unit out. So that's the new and improved method of doing it in 2021. Here's the rods, and now we're ready to go back in because we've swapped it. Where's the old one?
There's the old one.
All right, so on the reinstall, what we had to do was we took one bolt. I used the floor jack while Scott picked up the whole assembly, and then used the upper control arm to get everything in place and really muscled on this while I put the jack underneath and supported it and raised it up at the same time. And he guided this up in there. And while it was close, we stuck one bolt on the side, and that'll still give us the space we need to get the lower fork in on the arm.
All right, so this is Audi update video. We put all the suspension back together and, you know, made sure everything was real nice and tight and took it around the block, and we heard some clunking, and that, you know, clunking is never good. So we heard clunks coming from up here on the top, and my guess is it was the rubber donuts because I didn't change them. I just reused them instead of replacing them. So that's one thing, is those were probably extra worn. And then the lower bushings we noticed for the lower control arms, I don't know if I can really get a shot, but the lower bushings might be toast under there. So I'll do the update with the